A month ago, there were reports of drug stockout at Barra Regional Referral Hospital, which serves the whole of the Western Region catchment area. Besides delays to supply drugs by National Drug Authority, the hospital director revealed that incoming patients subsidize drugs available, and this literally tells you that most are on supportive drugs.
But you walk in any drug outlet today, you can pick one capsule of ampicillin. One. Because that is the money you have in your pocket, and the pharmacist or whoever is responsible there does not stop to say, wait a minute, if I give you this one capsule, I am doing something wrong.
Surprisingly, during the launch of the pharmacology clinical program at Barra University, medical professors pointed out negligence among medics as far as prescription of drugs is concerned.
No single physician in the whole wide world, or any healthcare professional for that matter, would be able to know all the effects of medications that exist. So patients are given drugs that they should not be given, and these drugs interact dangerously with other drugs. They interact with the food that they eat, with the disease that they are suffering itself, and so on.
Professor Robert Tom King, a visiting professor, argued that although the research on how many people die of taking multiple drugs known as polypharmacy remains scanty, the effect remains real and harmful to consumers.
Patients also often realize that when they become sicker, it could be a side effect of the drugs which they are taking. So we do a lot of harm to our patients, not just in Uganda, but across the world. And we don't realize that. Drugs have many harmful effects than beneficial effects.
You must go on to follow that patient to see that the patient is benefiting from the medicines. But who has been doing that? Nobody. I want to believe that the clinical pharmacists we are starting to train here today will know what the role of a pharmacist is.
As a result, Dr. Guang, who also doubles as the head of pharmacy at Barra University, testified to have seen countless cases of patients who have become victims as a result of errors made by medics.
Until that person gets into a pharmacist who is serious, to know that what's causing the cough is not the disease exactly, but the drug for high blood pressure which is prescribed. And I want to believe that Barra University today has started a journey of training this caliber of persons to help us in this country and even beyond.
Besides, he expressed ultimate fears over a few pharmacists in the country as he breaks down the figures.
With a current training of 25 per year, we need like 30 years to train 600 if the population of Uganda remains the same and if nobody goes out of this country, which is impossible.
On the other hand, teachers of medicines raised eyebrows over failing ethical standards in the practicing medics, stressing that cases of bribery amongst them is evident. Report by Halson Kagure for Urban TV.
To assure optimal outcome for my patients,